off the other side of the building.
Stop, and then I would restart again. And then this is bacon. No, this is Kevin.
Hi, Kevin.
better known as Kevin Bacon. Yeah. My God, it's still really smoking.
Yeah.
It's still active.
I see what, yeah. And then I would stop filming and then start again when you can like redo it. But one long thing is too long. Interested how we're all interested, right?
Yeah, I'm fascinated. I always love watching America.
Do you? Yeah, you do, right? My son does 911 rescue. Okay. So yeah, he's into, I mean, it's really smoking. Holy crap.
It's even more fun to come to Philadelphia. That's how I got the budget. Can you just make some move here for a stretcher?
Sure.
Stretcher
right
against the wall here.
Yeah.
Smoke stuff.
The what? No, but that's a firefighter that just came out.
Oh, wow.
So far, nobody's been hurt, thank God.
Oh, that's good.
But he's obviously a little bit in distress. Because he's a paramedic, the guy in a uniform.
He's probably getting checked out for smoke inhalation.
Yeah.
They always get checked out for smoke inhalation. You know, that can kill you.
Yes.
If you're breathing a little bit of smoke, that, I mean, it can go pretty bad.
And that's the chief right there, Thorne. That, the guy in the other hat's the chief of police. I mean, here, come over here. He had to say thank you. I wouldn't want that job.
I would have gone braver though. But I'm not. Why rescue and why PD?
We're in the building. So you got out of the building.
Yeah. I think everybody got out.
Do you know what happened?
I didn't hear any alarm. I just heard the sirens, and then I heard commotion in the hallway, and I was like, what's going on?
Smoke?
I didn't smell anything. I'm on this side, though.
So I'm on that side, and I was on a Zoom call, and my coworkers are making fun of the sounds in the background.
Yeah. Oh, that's so funny.
Thank you.
desk in a building like this six-story building where the fire was located, because it's a non-fire building and you have to go up the staircase all the way to the top floor. So it takes a while, and it's did a very nice job. We have numerous hand lines. We have a device called a cock-off nozzle, specifically designed for fire entrance and cock-off, which is the space I told you about between the roof and the top floor ceiling. And we were able to use that hose line effectively, that special tool. And around a little after 5 o'clock, we called the fire under control. And it's right now just making sure there's no other hot spots or anything inside the numerous apartments that were affected by this fire.
How many apartments were affected?
We had at least 3 or 4 apartments that were affected. The front of this building on the right hand side.
Is it correct beyond this building to the hot block?
I'm sorry?
Beyond that building to any of the others?
No, none of the other buildings. It was isolated to 303 East 37th Street. But that area above the ceiling I told you about enabled the fire to travel, and that's why we had numerous apartments involved in the front section.
No injuries?
Yeah, fortunate, no civilian injuries, and I was just told as of this briefing, no fire department injuries as well. So that's very good news.
Do you have where it started?
Fire marshals are on scene, and they're actively trying to determine the cause and origin of the fire, but at this point, no, I do not know the cause of it. I think they'll have to assess what, all likelihood, those top floor apartments where the fire was actually located. There's a lot of damage.
Anything else we're missing? You want to?
Sorry?
Anything else that we're missing that you want to add?
No, that's about it for my.
Very good. Thank you, Chief.
Appreciate it. Hi, Chief.